We all wake up with our cell phones in our hand. It has become one of the most important part of our life. All of us are connected to our friends through voice calls, maybe internet or SMS or other media. Hello everyone, I am Skand Gupta of second year IIT with my friend Amardeep Kumar of second year EC. We are going to explain you how does a cellular mobile communication takes place. First of all, to understand this, we have to know what a cell is. A cell is a hexagonal area covered by a base station. Now what is base station? Basically a base station is a mobile tower which we see in our surroundings. When several of these cells are connected to each other, they form a cellular network. And cellular, from here the word mobile cellular communication is derived. Now let's see how a basic communication process takes place. Suppose you have a cell phone C1 and you are calling your friend who has a cell phone C2. Now whenever you call, your information is sent to the nearest base station and that base station sends the information to mobile switching center. Now what is mobile switching center? A mobile switching center is a center which is connected to all the base stations of an area. Now when you are calling, mobile switching center locates where the required cell phone is and it connects to the base station to that area and that base station sends the information to C2. That's how a simple communication process takes place. Now let's see how long distance communication takes place. Now first of all, we need to know what a central office is. A central office is an office which covers all the MSCs of a larger area and they are connected to each other placed across the world through satellites. Now you have a friend in USA and you are calling to him from here. Now whenever you call, your information is sent to the base station and then base station send that information to MSC, and here MSC checks whether the call is a short range distance or a long range distance. In this process it is long distance, so the MSC send the information to central office, then central office directly connect to the central office in USA, and then that central office send the information to MSC, then MSC to the base station and base station to the cell phone. That's how a long distance communication takes place. Whenever we call, we have an uninterrupted two-way communication. We speak and listen at the same time. How does that happen? Because we use two different frequencies here. One for the transmitting signal, that is for speaking, and one for receiving signal, that is for listening. That's how we have a duplex communication, or in simpler words, uninterrupted two-way communication. Now, base station switching. Now, when we move, we talk, we have an uninterrupted calling. Now, the MSC locates where the cell phone is, keeps records where the cell phone is going, and it connects to the nearest base station who has a maximum signal strength. That's how it happens. Thank you for watching the video. Hope you like it.